high-definition displays are pushing tremendous boundaries in terms of quality imagery and color reproduction. While we welcome these technologies to enhance our perception of digital imagery, we have encountered mismatches in color reproduction between different displays, a byproduct of metameric failures. Specifically, these colorimetric mismatches are directly related to the illumination technology of new displays. When users attempted to match phosphor-based CRT displays to newer non-phosphor-based displays, they could not simultaneously achieve a visual match and a colorimetric match. This made calibration difficult and raised questions about using non-phosphor-based displays for critical applications, as well as the colorimetric measurement mathematics, the CIE 1931 2-degree standard observer color matching functions. These color matching functions represent an average relationship between wavelength and color matching sensitivity in humans. While a number of other functions to model observer perception have been developed, the 1931 color matching functions remain the industry standard built into imaging and calibration colorimeters. In the past, this has not been an issue. A pair of chromaticity coordinates known as D65 white has been the target calibration standard and has been implemented when calibrating CRT displays. However, if we take a look at the spectral power distribution of a typical CRT display, the spectra of its red, green, and blue phosphors have a wide bandwidth and overlap a fair amount. Comparatively, the spectra of professional-grade LED displays are narrower. While this can significantly improve color gamut, it makes it more likely for colors to be mismatched if viewed by a population of observers who are naturally diverse when it comes to their spectral sensitivity. This is problematic for artists. Filmmakers go through exhaustive efforts to ensure that their imagery is displayed as intended, relying on facilities to promise rigorous color correction. If displays on today's market behave in this manner, it becomes increasingly more difficult for post facilities to assure accurate color reproduction or equipment setup. I have expanded upon this phenomena by generating a simulation to understand the consequences of metameric failures. In the simulation, I begin with the fully driven primary spectra of a CRT display and use matrix algebra to ensure that it is calibrated to D65 white and yields the appropriate chromaticity coordinates for the 1931 observer model. With this calibrated spectra, I then use a number of other color matching functions to view the calibrated CRT. Each of these color matching functions represent a viewer observing the display. These other functions are derived from the extremes of a diverse population of observers. Combined, the intention is to determine a best single average chromaticity match, if it exists, for all observers. I then use the same matrix algebra technique to scale the fully driven primary spectra of a number of new high-definition displays so that their chromaticity coordinates will match with respect to any one of these new color matching functions or observers. Lastly, I determine the corresponding chromaticity coordinates of the matched high-definition display in terms of the 1931 observer, and assess the magnitude of the difference between the standard D65 white and the offset of the observer's new match. So when simulated, there is a noticeable shift of the cluster of points such that it is not centered around D65 white. This suggests that for a group of diverse observers, the 1931 color matching functions are not a central representation of this population. We can correct this, however, by a simple geometric shift of chromaticity coordinates in the CIE XY chromaticity space. This point is by no means a perfect match for all observers, but perhaps may be indicative of a more satisfactory calibration, which still remains a function of the display illumination technology itself. I have extended this research by inviting participants to assess visual mismatches between either an LED backlit display or a fluorescent backlit display against a calibrated CRT display. Participants were asked to adjust the chromaticity of the LED or fluorescent displays until visual matches were achieved with the CRT display. For a population viewing both of the new display technologies, empirical evidence supports a new and unique mean 1931 chromaticity to represent D65 white. Additionally, it reveals a significant magnitude of observer variability, very prevalent when observers made visual matches with the narrow bandwidth LED display. My intention is that these findings support the creation of a more robust calibration standard for high-definition displays.